Hello everyone, I welcome you all. My name is Dr. Savidhan Suresh Anoni. Today I am going to conduct a lecture on computer fundamentals, introduction of computer fundamentals. Now the world is changing. Called technological advancement. You all are aware of how it is important today's era. So continuing with this, let's move with the introduction of what do you mean by computer? It is something which reduces your work. Like doing a manual work, now it's going to online with some shortcuts. You can say reduce your physical movement. So it can be defined as anything which reduces your work, transform in a minimum less, or you can lay a minimum efforts, by something that is called a computer. A computer is a machine, it helps you conduct everything with less exercise, with less movement of physical movements, get the results in a short time with accuracy. So this is the latest tool we are using nowadays on daily basis. Next, this is the characteristic of computer. First is high speed. This is the most important feature of, or you can say characteristic of computer, that use high speed. Because while doing something on manual basis, you need time. Using a computer actually gives you more speed and it will reduce your this accuracy. Doing some work, doing some calculation, we may fail sometime. We may be wrong. Using a computer, if you give the right command, it will give you a correct answer. Accuracy is much higher. Storage capacity. After, like being a human being, after every small time, you can say, we forget something while reading something else, while doing something else, forget something what we are doing currently doing. So storage capacity in the computer, that keeps something a more longer time. You can access it at any time you whenever you need it. It's a plus point. Sorry for the some interaction due to technical thing. Next characteristic is diligence. Diligence means to work and accurately. Next is versatility. Versatility means it has so many functions and activities which conducts all together in a few seconds, or you can say very minimum time. Specialty of the computer, automation. Computer runs on automation, like it's all typically machine and it is all technical things. You just need to give a command and it will work for you. It's a reduction in paperwork. Don't have to do anything like paper, note on the notes, kind of things. You can just open the some Word file and you can start typing. So whatever you want to type, you can do anything. It is just reducing your paperwork. Actually, not the physical work, but you can. A soft copy is there, so you can keep in a soft copy. As you can say, it's the power of remembering. Yes, the other side is storage capacity. As a maximum storage capacity, always has the power of remembering. It can save your data the longer time, unless and until it is get corrupted or it is not being get deleted. The other thing is, it doesn't have any IQ and it's not a feeling because it is not a human being. Next is the computer system hardware. It's a very basic thing where everyone knows about it, but just for the sake of syllabus, you have to see there are types of devices. First, input devices. Basically, now most of the people are using a laptop, but earlier it was like some devices extra you're supposed to add with the desktop. First is keyboard, which is used to type something, command. Then the mouse, again joystick, light pen, trackball, scanner, microphone, barcode reader. next is output devices. Output devices means what? It uses the results. Printer, monitor, ran the projector. Secondary storages. Yes, secondary storages means like some other where you can collect your data. That is hard disk, additional hard disk. You can say that movable hard disk. We usually have right now. CD, compact discs, DVD, digital video disc, drive, floppy. Floppy is now outdated, but still is a part of it. Again, internal components. What actually computers come along with? It is a CPU, motherboard, and RAID, random access memory. So it is the computer has a memory basically in two types: primary memory and secondary memory. Primary memory is random access memory and read-only memory, which allows you to access and just to read the game. You do not have any right to permission to or to change anything. Again, secondary memory, where the magnetic or magnetic disk in which your whole data is saved. Now, what's the interaction between user and the computer? There are the elements of computer interaction. First is input devices. It's the devices which we have already seen in the earlier slide, that all the devices that mouse keyboard we use do the input to the computer. Text entry. Yes, for that we use a keyboard to do the entry. Yes, mouse we use to draw pointers. Calculate DC, that is a monitor. And memory, that is storage, and the processing which runs inside the computer. Interaction between user and the computer. Elements of human user interaction. Input and output panel. It is based on the one platform only. How to interaction with in the input and output panels. Next, information storage in memory. Whatever we use to type the computer, we use to save. Saves in the memory. Information is processed and applied. Yes, while we are saving it, while writing it, it is get processed accordingly and then get saved. Okay. On this topic, we will be having interaction in the class. See you in the class.